Today and NACTA.
Hey everybody, I'm Mike Golic, and are you ready to test your college sports knowledge? Join me as I host the Fan Exam presented by Unilever, a new live trivia game show taking place at 8 p.m. Eastern every Tuesday and Thursday through December 17th at thefanexam.com. We're giving out some great prizes every week and at the end of the season. Plus, it's free to play. Show your smarts as you compete against college fans from all over the country. Sign up now at thefanexam.com. It's the Fan Exam presented by Unilever.
Tip-off is just around the corner. Let's get the final word from 49ers head coach Ron Sanchez. Brought to you by Bojangles. It's Bo time. Here with the coach is Matt Swearat.
Welcome back to Halton. The Niners tonight taking on the Panthers of Georgia State. We're joined by head coach Ron Sanchez. And coach, good to get back on the floor here tonight, taking on a good Georgia State team.
Yeah, no, definitely. Looking forward to see, how we improved from the last time we were on the floor.
What did you take in that last game after you went back and watched some tape? And, and it wasn't a win for you guys, but you talked about how hard they played.
Yeah, no, I think that we played hard. You know, their effort was definitely there. There was a level of gratitude for being on the floor, which as a coach definitely is a great starting point. But we had a lot of defensive breakdowns, et cetera, things that we needed to address, not from a coaching standpoint, but just from an emphasis and application standpoint. I think that they do understand what it is that we need to do. But again, you know, being in your first game, I definitely expected some slippage, and I'm hoping that we can grow from the last one.
So many new faces in the mix. How's practice been since it's been a week now since we played?
Practice has been interesting. You know, we're still dealing with a few injuries or issues related to, COVID. So, breaking up our teams into equal competitive groups has been challenging because we don't have enough. But at the same time, I think that, we found a way to navigate through those obstacles and really went in and worked hard this past week. And, again, I'm just looking forward to seeing how much we've grown since the last time we stepped out.
We talked on Tuesday night during the coaches show about Milo Supica, who went out with an injury in the second half last Friday. How's he doing? He did practice on Tuesday, so how's it been since?
No, he's good. He's good. He'll be back in the starting lineup today and ready to go. Our trainer, John, did a great job making sure that, that he's okay and there's nothing lingering. I'm hoping that he can, really play the same way that he did the last time out. I thought he did a great job when he was on the floor and, expect to watch his continued growth.
Georgia State's been able to play three games so far. They had that four-overtime thriller in Atlanta against Georgia Tech, won that game, most recently losing at Mercer. Mercer, really good team, and they held below 70.
Yeah, no, this is a very talented basketball team. I mean, they have, multiple guys that can score in double figures. Some are averaging double figures, 20-point scorers. Then they have guys that can have 20 on any given night. You know, their tempo is so fast. You know, they really get the ball up the floor quickly, whether it's a score or a stop, and they really try to punish you in transition. We got to do a great job in transition. I think it's the reason why they were able to beat Georgia Tech. I think that they had that type of tempo of a game, and it really played to their favor.
Also, they've gone out in the transfer ranks and got some guys from some pretty good programs. And, they're not just four or five deep. They've got multiple guys that come off the bench and certainly play well.
They did. They went and got a couple of high major transfers just to add to the talent that they already had. Obviously, Coach Hunter was there before, and, he put a great program together before he went and took over at Tulane. And I think that he's Coach Lanier has continued to build on that, and they did. They brought in some really good talent. It's going to be a great challenge for us, but again, we're looking forward to it.
Corey Allen's their top three-point shooter, shooting almost 60%. He's made 11 so far this season. Talk about their perimeter game. It's not just getting up and on the floor. They can shoot it out there as well.
Yeah, no, they got multiple guys shooting, above the 50% range from three-point line. And, they're guys that are very complete, so they can score in transition. They can score in the half court. But they can also dribble it. They got a lot of quickness, at the one, two, and three-guard positions, and they're on the floor at the same time. I think any of those guys can break out of the offense at any moment and go create some offense of their own. And then the interior, they have some some big guys with some size and athleticism and a lot of rebounding abilities on the offensive glass. And we're going to have to really show up today to be able to compete well.
You know, it's also a start of what we hope is going to be quite a few games in a short period of time. And at this point, you know, it's been so long since you guys got out there and played basketball, even though you've played one game so far. I know you're going to welcome a bunch of games in a short period of time.
Yeah, we just want to play. You know, it's hard to, you know, really get a rhythm of play and you know, get work on your rotations and, you know, really get your bench established and get guys into a routine and a pattern so they can feel comfortable on the floor on game day. You know, the only way you get that is through playing experience. And I am looking forward to maybe practicing a little less and playing a little more and continuing to grow. I think that's the best way for us right now.
Give us a couple of keys quickly for a win here tonight.
I think for us, you know, transition defense, rebounding, you know, hustle plays, those 50-50 balls are going to be key. You know, we really focus on limiting the transition points, you know, not giving them anything on the offensive glass, and taking care of the basketball. I think, you know, those keys will give us an opportunity to be happy, you know, at the end of the second half.
Coach, thanks so much. Good luck tonight.
Thank you.
Head coach Ron Sanchez back with the tip-off, the Niners, and Georgia State coming up. Niner basketball from Learfield, IMG College.
Domino's week-long carry-out deal means you could carry out three topping pizzas for $7.99 each every day. That's right, $7.99 each, and every day means any day. But just in case...
This is the gold standard for hoops.
Five soup against side. Boy, that down back to Shep. He's open. Three ball the way. Good! Oh, my. Block. Unbelievable. Milos Supica gives it to Shepard. He'll drive to the rim. He throws it down. Shepard driving to the bucket. Floating shot. Good! Takes the shot. It's good. A three-pointer. How about that? Got blocked. Milos gets it back. Puts it up. And he scores. Down straight away. Three. Got it. Shepard deep three on the way. Good!
On the Charlotte Sports Network from Learfield, IMG College. Welcome to live play-by-play coverage of 49ers basketball. Charlotte basketball is brought to you by Ortho Carolina. You improved. Atrium Health, the best for the Carolinas. Great Clips, it's going to be great. Carolina Ford Dealers. Ford is built for the Carolinas. See your Carolina Ford dealer, proud partner of 49er Athletics. Harris Teeter, where 49er fans shop for groceries. Now, here's the voice of the 49ers, Matt Swerad.
And welcome back inside Halton Arena. Matt Swerad with Trevor Wilt. Back in the studio is Mario Washington. Game two of the season for the Niners as they take on Georgia State. Last time the Panthers were here in the Queen City, you get to go all the way back to the 25th of November in 2006. And in that game, the Niners won at 72-63. Coach Sanchez would love to keep this high-flying Panthers team in the 60s here tonight, Trevor. If they do that, the Niners feel pretty confident they can get their first win of the year.
Yeah, it's going to be a tall task for sure, and communication is huge. And, of course, that's huge on any defense, but particularly the way that the Charlotte 49ers run that pack line defense. So it's going to be very, very execution-based for the Charlotte 49ers on the defensive end when it comes to Jerry Matos, Milo Supico, who missed basically the entire second half. You got Bryce Williams. We've seen so many great flashes. Jackson Threadgill, we saw him for 26 minutes. They're going to be led by, of course, Jordan Shepherd and Jameer Young in the backcourt, but it's going to be the other guys who are going to have to be able to communicate to really be able to perform here tonight for the Niners to slow down this Georgia State offense.
Now the Niners warming up to our right, and if you didn't listen on the opener last Friday, the Niners have changed which side of the floor is theirs where their bench is. That way, when the players come on the floor and leave the floor, they don't crisscross with the opposing team. But it is a little odd for those of us that have seen games in this building for so long to see the Niners on the other side of the floor. And of course, we have all the COVID protocol that has gone through here with the benches being moved apart, set back. It definitely is a different look. It didn't seem, though, we talked about depth perception of the sideline with some balls that were heading towards the baseline on the sideline last Friday, the depth perception, more so with the sideline, it seemed like it gave a couple of guys some difficulty.
Yeah, it really did. And talking to the players as well, they saw a little difficulty as well when shooting that outside shot. Able to connect from the outside, but nonetheless, it's weird with no fans in. But hey, look, Matt, we got about 50 or 60 or so in here. So I think the players get some for both teams and the coaches as well. So excited to announce the starters and excited to kind of get into tonight.
Let's pause right now, 10 seconds for station ID. This is Niner Basketball from Learfield, IMG College.
These are your teams, and this is your town. 7:30 The Game, ESPN.
Niner fans, it's bow time. When the holiday season is your busy season, drop a big bow box on it, because with 8 pieces of chicken, biscuits, fixins, and tea for just $19.99, if it's Christmas time, it's bow time. Just about getting set for the national anthem, and then we'll have the player introductions after that. So let's take our final pregame break, come back with the starting lineups, and we'll tip it off here tonight, Friday night basketball at Halton Arena. The Niners take on the Panthers of Georgia State. Coming up next, this is Niner Basketball from Learfield.
Charlotte basketball is sponsored by Progressive's Home Insurance. Get your quote at progressive.com today.
Welcome back inside Halton Arena. The Niners here tonight taking on the Panthers of Georgia State. Matt Swarad, Trevor Wilt with you. And back in the studio is Mario Washington. Let's get to the starters here tonight. First for Georgia State out of Atlanta, their head coach Rob Lanier in his second season. And here are the starting five. A 6'2 senior from Ypsilanti, Michigan, Corey Allen. He's a transfer from Detroit. 16 points a game, shooting 58% from the three-point line. A 6'4 senior from Douglasville, Georgia, Kane Williams, 13.7 points, 6.7 rebounds a game. 6-foot junior from Indianapolis, Indiana, Justin Roberts, he's their leading scorer. He's a transfer from DePaul out of the Big East Conference. He's averaging 19.7 points and 5.3 rebounds a game. He's shooting 50% from the three-point line. 6'6 sophomore from Memphis, Tennessee, and a transfer from the University of Memphis, Ryan Boyce, 7.7 points, 4 rebounds a game. And the final starter is a 6'9 redshirt junior from Kinshasa, Congo, and a transfer from the University of Cincinnati, Aleo Sosime, 16 points a game, which is second best in the team, and 7.7 rebounds a game. The Panthers right now 2-1 on the season, coming off a loss their last time out on the road against Mercer in Macon, Georgia. Now for the 49ers, head coach Ron Sanchez in his third season. Same five starters that began the game last Friday night. 6'2 sophomore guard from Hyattsville, Maryland, Jameer Young, Conference USA's freshman of the year last year, and 10 points, 5 rebounds in the opener. A 6'7 sophomore from Huntersville, North Carolina, Bryce Williams, 5 points and 3 rebounds in the ECU game. 6'9 senior from Belgrade, Serbia, Milo Supica, 7 points, 3 rebounds in that first ball game. He didn't play a lot in the second half because he hurt his right knee. It was a bruised knee, but he's good to go here tonight. 6'5 graduate transfer from Santo Domingo in the Dominican Republic. He played at Dayton last season, Jerry Matos. He had 14 points in his Niners debut and 6 rebounds. Played in 26 games a year ago for the Dayton Flyers. And the point guard, a 6'4 redshirt senior from Asheville. He came here from the University of Oklahoma, Jordan Shepherd. 15 points in the opener, 5 rebounds in that game. Last season, third team, all Conference USA. Niners, their second game of the season. They dropped the opener against East Carolina, looking to even things up here tonight. 30th meeting all time between Charlotte and Georgia State. The Niners have never lost the Panthers at home. They're 15-0 and look to continue that streak here tonight. Milo Supica is going to jump center for the Niners against Sosime for Georgia State. And in the first half, Charlotte going left to right, their home white uniform CLT across the front. Georgia State, their road royal blue, with Georgia State in white across the front. The Panthers win the tip into the front court, and Roberts, the point guard, with the ball. He'll give it up to Boyce on the left. He'll get it to Allen, back out to Roberts out top. Roberts guarded by Young. Niners in a man-to-man. Now out high with it is Boyce, looking inside, and Milo stepping in and taking the pass away. That was intended for Sosimi. Niners first possession tonight, no score, game just underway. Supica high post on the right, guarded by Sosimi away from the basket. Gets it to Matos. He'll dribble out to the right, go back left. Young is open for three, banks it in. And the Niners have a 3-0 lead as Jameer Young, using the window, has put the Niners on top.
Yeah, Matt, you love to see the aggression right there from one of the top players in Conference USA, and Jameer Young being able to separate himself thanks to a couple good picks there from Milo Supica.
Now the Panthers with it in the front court. Roberts to the baseline, throws it back outside. With it now as Allen goes right inside Sosimi. Left it goes in the corner, wide open for three, and making it to tie the game is Kane Williams. That's just his second made three. He was 1-for-12 coming in from the arc, but that one ties the game.
Yeah, whenever you're that open, Matt, you got to be able to shoot that ball if you're Williams.
Now Bryce Williams going baseline, goes to the right corner to Young. He'll skip it left now to Shepherd. Shot clock at 14. Shep on the left, dribble drive into the paint, kicks it now to Young in the corner. He'll drive baseline, get low, scoop shot, up and in. He rolled that one with some spin off the glass with his left hand from the right side. He has all five Niner points. Niners by a bucket.
Yeah, Matt, and we've seen that circus shot for the last now season and a half right now from Jameer Young. He's so athletic when he gets to that rim and so poised as well with that body control.
Roberts on a drive. He'll get it in the left corner. It goes to Williams. Williams backing it out. Now attacks down the lane. Floater up off the back of the iron, and it drops through and ties the game at five.
That's still really good defense right there for Jerry Matos. He met him out by the three-point line. He knows that Williams, like you just said, his first three of the game, he knows he doesn't like to shoot it, was welcome into the paint. He did come to the paint. The body was there. It's just the execution. Better play right there for Williams.
Now Jordan Shepherd on the left pulls up on a three, and it's no good. Shep missing that one. Rebound to Georgia State. Panthers bringing up the floor. Now a long three for Allen. Back rim, no good. Rebound tipped and controlled by Bryce Williams of the 49ers.
Yeah, it's going to be some gang rebounds for the Charlotte 49ers against this team that love to come from the perimeter for those rebounds.
Shepherd, right side, putting up a three. Back rim, no good. Rebound in the hands of Georgia State. Allen has it up the near sideline, gives it up. Now Williams driving to the hoop. Floating shot is up off the rim, no good. On the rebound, there's a foul. And it's going to be on the Panthers. It's going to be on Ryan Boyce. And that'll be his first, team's first. It'll be Charlotte basketball. It is a tie game with 17:04 to go in this first half.
Yeah, love the rebounding so far by the Charlotte 49ers, and even that last shot right there from Shep. You see right now a physicality of Jameer Young that we normally don't see in the first opening minutes of a ball game. He was able to drive baseline, fake three, drive baseline, find a wide open Jordan Shepherd as well, although not able to knock down the shot, but still love that shot attempt right there by the Niners and what they've seen so far in offense and even the defensive end, making it tough for Georgia State to put up any easy baskets.
Now Jameer Young's got to bring it up the floor for the Niners, guarded by Roberts. Into the front court, hands it off, Matos with it. Out of Williams out top. Bryce looking inside, there's nothing there. Dribbles left, gets it back to Matos in the wing. Now to Shepherd, back out to Milos. Dribble drive, attacks the hoop, double team, tough shot. He forced it up, it's no good. Here comes Georgia State, they want to run out. Williams down the floor, and he's not able to finish, but he's fouled. And he will go to the free throw line. The foul is going to be on the Niners, Jerry Matos.
Yeah, 1 through 4 for Georgia State, the Panthers. It doesn't matter who gets the ball from that 1 through 4 position. Heck, even Sosime as the 5, they're going to get the ball and they're going to push it as fast as they can. If they're the only ones who touch the basketball, they dribble it 6-7 times down the court. That's all that matters to them. They want to get up early shots and they want to see this game get up there into the 80s and 90s.
Kane Williams is at the line and he makes the first one. Only a 44% free throw shooter through three games. He's now 13 for 28 at the line. Senior from Douglasville, Georgia. He puts the Panthers on top 6-5, 16:39 left to go in this first half. And he's good on both here. The Panthers had gone to the bench and they have Caleb Scott now in the game. He's a 6'7 freshman out of Virginia. Also coming in, Evan Johnson, a 6-foot freshman from Durham. The Niners have brought in Jackson Threadgill, 6'6 freshman out of Davidson Day. And now the Niners trail 7-5. Young brings it across the half court line. He's guarded out there by Johnson. Goes left, gets it to Shepherd. Shot clock at 17. Shep on the wing, now to Milos out high. Over to Threadgill. On the right side, goes behind his back, gives it up on the wing. This is Young. Lost the dribble in the hands now of Williams of Georgia State. He'll drive down the lane. Shot is blocked away by Bryce Williams. Now the Niners going the other way. Young down the lane, puts the shot up off the back of the iron. No good, but following the miss with a tip in is Supica. Niners tie the game at 7.
I love the tenacity right there from Milo Supica.
Another block from behind by Bryce Williams. He swats the shot from Scott away. Niners have possession. 7-7 game, 4 minutes gone by. Niners in the front court, Young out top. Bounce past the high post, Milos, he'll turn face the hoop, get it back over to Shep. Shepherd left side, step back, three-pointer, nothing but net. Knocking that one down to put the Niners on top now. 10-7, it's a 5-0 run for the 49ers.
Bryce Williams looking a lot like LeBron James with those chase down blocks over there, Matt.
Good start for the sophomore out of Huntersville. Now Williams out between the circles, picked up by Young. He'll give it up. Here's a deep shot. It's knocked down by Ryan Boyce, the Memphis transfer. His third made three-pointer this season ties the game at 10.
And that's the prettiest shot right there from Ryan Boyce. But again, like you said, the Memphis transfer, able to knock down that shot. Anybody's going to let it loose. Doesn't matter how they're shooting the ball. If they're open, they're going to shoot it.
Threadgill, bounce pass to Supik at the right block, has it knocked away from behind, but runs it down. Puts it back on the deck, spins, goes right, jump hook, no good. Rebound Bryce Williams, but a foul on Bryce. Over the back, that'll be his first personal foul. Take us to our first timeout on the floor with 14:48 to play in the opening half. Niners 10, Georgia State 10. This is Charlotte Basketball from Learfield IMG College. With it right now, Moore. Now knocked away. Niners come away with it. Young up the floor on the right side. Jameer Young back in after that timeout. Threadgill gives it to Shepard. Looking inside, knocked away, stolen away. JoJo Toppin getting his hand in there, knocking the pass away, and came up with a steal. Here comes Georgia State. Roberts in the front court, right side, picked up by Matos. They go left. Johnson almost traveled, gives it up to Roberts. He'll step back, take the three. It's no good, as Matos had run out on him. Niners by two at the ball. 7 minutes gone by here in the first half. Shepard on the right side splits a double team. Now to the free throw line. Gets it back to Young on the right. Inside it goes to Rosetto. That right block. He'll back his man down. Left hand up and in off the glass. Anzac's first basket of the season.
Yeah, love to see right there like that from Anzac Rosetto again. That's only going to make Milos Šupica play better, because if he sees his backup and Anzac Rosetto, who only averaged just about half a minute a game last year, to come in and do this, bad things there for Milos and good things here for Anzac.
Niners by four, 12:25 left opening half. Here's a drive by Moore, and he's hit in the lane. He split a double team, and in doing so, I think it was Anzac, it was, who got him. That's a big body trying to get out of the way.
It definitely is. He's slimmed up, though, hasn't he, Matt?
He's worked hard. He's just a big, young man.
He is a large human being. But I love the fact that, yeah, that he comes in, he brings that energy that Georgia State's going to bring as well on the offensive end. And, again, it's only going to make Milos better. And we all know that whenever Milos is performing at his peak, he's one of the best centers in all of Conference USA.
Kane Williams back on the floor. He's got it, guarded by Young on the wing. Gets it to top, and he'll go left. Shots up and no good, but a foul on the 49ers. On the shot, so free throws coming for Toppin. The foul's going to be on Matos. That'll be Jerry Matos' second personal foul. Looks like Coach Sanchez will go to the bench and bring Bryce Williams back in.
That was just bad positioning right there for Jerry Matos. It's not like he had a hand up and got caught with the cookie jar as well. It was just, he just had bad position right there, and now he knows it too, and he's ticked off at himself, and now he'll have to probably sit on the bench probably for the next 6 to 7 minutes, if not a little bit more.
And the first one by Toppin is off the back of the rim and drops through. Toppin played 18 games for the Georgia Bulldogs before he transferred to Georgia State, just down the road from Athens to Atlanta. Redshirt sophomore. Lefty shooter, second shot is also good, makes it now 14-12. Just over 12 minutes to go in this first half. Jameer Young gets it across the timeline. Niners going left to right here in the opening half. Shepard out between the circles, back to Young in the wing. Now to Rosetto at the high post. Looks inside, finds the cutting Young, who's going to be fouled by Roberts and go to the free throw line for a couple now. Good pass by Anzac to find the cutter, Jameer Young. Free throws after the timeout, 11:56 to play. First half here at Halton, the Niners 14, Georgia State 12. This is Charlotte Basketball from Learfield, IMG College.
It's bow time.
So it's game time, and you got a bunch of rabbits.
Well, back here at Halton Arena, the Niners on top 14-12 over Georgia State. Just under 12 minutes to play in the opening half. Chick-fil-A will donate 10 meals per assist for the entire season. Donations will be made to the Jamil Niner Pantry, which provides food assistance to UNC Charlotte students. Out of the timeout, Threadgill in the game with Young, Bryce Williams, and Zach Rosetto and Jordan Shepard. Young was fouled going to the basket before the timeout. A couple of free throws coming for the Conference USA Freshman of the Year last year. Eight times he won the Freshman of the Week award a year ago. And his first free throw is no good. He's got 5 points so far in the game.
Again, love to see him being so confident in his shot, being so aggressive here early, and that's the only thing that's really going to propel him and really hold him back this season of not winning maybe a Conference USA Player of the Year is him just not being aggressive. Whenever he is, I mean, he's one of the best players that you're going to find.
Well, out of character for him, he missed both free throws. Niners still by two, Georgia State with the ball. Allen, left elbow, picks the dribble up. He's guarded by Threadgill. He'll get it to Williams. Williams back out to Allen, out between the circles. So Simi sets a screen. Allen dribbles towards the right, shot clock down to four. Finds Simi back to Allen. He'll launch it, and he makes the three at the top of the key as the shot clock was about to run out.
Wow, they played 30 seconds of perfect defense to the Charlotte 49ers. They were there on the switches, and Zach Rosetto and Jackson Threadgill. Wonderful communication. Just a lucky prayer sometimes goes in.
Georgia State by one. Shepard to answer, and he does. Makes the triple at the top of the key. Niners 17, Georgia State 15.
Knowing that they lost Drew Edwards, one of their biggest three-point threats for the Charlotte 49ers, and also Cooper Robb. Shepard put it on himself, knowing he's got to make more threes. There's a foul there on Anzac Rosetto, and knowing he's got to make more threes, and Matt, he talked to us about it before on that bus ride, and we've already seen the aggression for him.
He worked really hard in the offseason on his deep jump shot, and he's now made two threes in the game tonight. Anzac picking up that second foul goes out, and now Supica back on the floor. But Anzac gave the Niners some nice minutes off the bench. Also coming in now for the first time is Caleb Stone Carrowell, redshirt freshman from Concord, replacing Shepard. So it's Stone Carrowell, Bryce Williams, Young, Supica, and Threadgill. Young team on the floor right now for the 49ers. Roberts behind the arc gets it to Allen. Straight away, guarded by Threadgill. And Williams shuffles his feet as he caught the pass on the left wing, trying to get rid of the ball for Toppin. He shuffled his feet and turns it over.
Yeah, and he did that just because it was Stone Carrowell. He actually got caught out of position. They were trying to find Toppin down low, but he had active hands on his closeout right there, which kind of got Williams to go back and forth with his hands.
Caleb Scott now back in the game for Georgia State, so Simi went out. Jameer Young in the front court gets it to Threadgill on the left side. Shot clock at 17. Now Stone Carrowell bounce pass to Young out top. 12 to shoot. Here's a moving screen on Milos Supica. Milos, as soon as the whistle was blown, he knew he did it.
Yeah, it's good to have coaches back now in Vic's. You got Vic Sfera, he's back as well. Cody Kimball, you got Aaron Ferdy. You got everybody back on staff, which is awesome. So they're over here, they're barking orders. And Matt, we noticed there was a little lack of communication in that first game, and it's good to have all the assistant coaches back going through everything, the whole COVID situation. And love to see that, and you just love to see the communication even in these learning moments.
Now Williams driving, blocked from behind by Caleb Stone Carrowell, but a foul. It's going to be on Caleb. But you forgot to mention the banner, Byron Dinkins, who's back on the sideline as well.
What a legend, man. Look, just look up in the Raptors right now, man. You got Byron Dinkins, number four, old Charlotte 49er logo. He was a stud, wasn't he?
Sure was. Now tying his shoe before the free throw. 10-13 to go. First half, Kane Williams to shoot a couple. Williams so far today, 7 points. He's 2 for 2 at the foul line, and this time he misses. He came in shooting 44% from the stripe, so he's now 2 out of 3.
Again, not the best shooter, but again, they don't care. They're like, hey, if you're open, if you can get to the basket, get it up. And they do care, of course. They want their high percentage shooters doing that. They have a lot of them, Justin Roberts being one of them. Same thing with Corey Allen, shooting over 50%, 55% from deep. That's unheard of.
Second free throw is good, so it's a 1-point Niner lead, 17-16. Halfway through this first half at Halton Arena. Young across the timeline, Niners the first half going left to right. Bryce Williams out top, one dribble, gives it to Threadgill. Now to Supica out top. Over to the right side it goes to Young. Fires one inside for Caleb Stone Carwell. Good catch. Turns, lets it fly, and it's good. Ball away up the right side of the lane. His first bucket tonight. Niners by three. Now Allen driving to the floor. Supica blocks him, but cleaning it up is Caleb Scott for Georgia State to make it a one-point game again, 19-18.
Again, the Niners, they have to get back and they have to build that wall. Yes, they did get that lucky block from Miklos Supica, but it was an easy offensive rebound for Georgia State because they crashed the boards. All their perimeter players do, and you saw that exactly exemplified right there from Lanier's staff.
Jameer Young right of the key behind the arc with eight to shoot. Guarded by Roberts. He'll find Caleb Stone Carwell. He'll drive, lay it up around the rim, no good. Rebound Williams, back up off the glass, and he scores. Good offensive rebound and basket for Bryce Williams. Niners by three once again. Now Williams driving down the lane. Shot partially blocked by Supica in the hands of Stone Carwell. Now to Threadgill in the backcourt. He'll wait and give it to Young. Jameer brings it across the timeline. Right-handed dribble near the right sideline. Now back to Caleb, over to Jackson Threadgill. On the left wing, dribbles towards the sideline. Now gets it back over to Stone Carwell. Shot clock at nine. They work it back to Young, right at the top of the key. Shot clock at four. Jameer dribbles out. Now to the left elbow. Pulls up, lets it fly. Off the back of the rim, no good. Milos fighting for the rebound. It's going to be saved by Scott on the end line by Georgia State. And here come the Panthers running out. Roberts right corner launching a three. Nothing but the bottom of the net on that one. Ties the game at 21.
Yeah, still proud of the Niner defense right there. They got back on defense. They went back. They built that wall. They built their line. But Jameer Young, you got to be a little bit more active on that closeout. But again, he was still there in position, which is a big thing for Ron Sanchez and his staff for them to implement.
This is more the pace of game the Niners were hoping for here tonight. Georgia State wants to run up and down the floor, but the Niners right now slowing them down. Here's a three missed by Bryce Williams from that left side. Rebound for Georgia State. Bringing it up the floor is Corey Allen. He'll give it up on the wing, get it right back. Now to Williams out between the circles. He'll get it back inside to Scott. Found the cutter on the baseline, and Ryan Boyce put it up and in to put the Panthers on top, 23-21.
Yeah, just better offense right there for Georgia State as Jameer Young starting to push the ball up the court, but again, a very young team out there right now, a couple sophomores, and a freshman as well. Then, of course, you got the senior here in Milos Supica. But again, a young team out there, still liking what I'm seeing right now for the Niners.
Jameer's going to drive to the basket. He drew the contact and the foul, and he'll go to the free throw line once again. So the foul is going to be on Caleb Scott. That'll be his first, and it's going to take us to a timeout. 7:06 to play here in the first half. Georgia State 23, Charlotte 21. This is Niner basketball from Learfield IMG College.
Charlotte basketball is sponsored by Progressive's Home Insurance. Get your quote at progressive.com today.
And welcome back inside of Halton Arena. Matt Swerheide with Trevor Wilk. The Niners with 7:06 to go in this first half. We'll have some free throws coming here for Jameer Young. He missed his last two attempts, so he'll go to the line. 23-21, Georgia State. Two shots coming. When the holiday season is your busy season, drop a big bow box on it. Because with chicken, biscuits, fixins, and tea for $19.99, it's bow time. First free throw is good by Jameer Young. Now it's 7 points in the game. One more to tie the game. Lefty lets it fly, and it's around the rim, bouncing around and going through. So it's a tie game now, 23 apiece. And here comes Georgia State, bringing it across the timeline, going from right to left. Out top, Evan Johnson with the basketball. Jordan Shepherd back in the game as he's checking Johnson. Out of the right side, it goes to Allen. Looking to the baseline. Shot is up by Boyce, no good. That would have been a three-pointer. Rebound to the Niners. Stone Carrowell with the rebound. In the game for the first time in his freshman season is Jared Garcia, 6'8 freshman who played his prep ball in Connecticut. He's from Texas. Niners can take the lead once again with a basket. Shot clock at 12, Shepherd out top. Bounce pass to the right side to Stone Carrowell. Bryce Williams trying to post up, they'll get it to him. Shot clock at 5, Garcia comes out, takes the jump shot. As the shot clock was winding out, he missed the three-point attempt on the right wing. Here comes Georgia State, tie game at 23. Panthers in the front court. Now pulling up, Johnson mid-range jumper, no good, over the back. So Simi puts it up, no good. On the rebound, over the back this time is Georgia State. It's going to be Ryan Boyce, the guilty Panther. So Sime, was he the one just called? I thought it was Boyce. So Sime grabbed the offensive rebound and missed the follow through.
Yeah, they're going to go.
But it's going to be on Sime. So on the second attempt, he gets called for the over the back personal foul. 6 minutes to play in the first half. Niners put it in play in the backcourt. Full court man to man for Georgia State, 23 apiece. Shep now in the front court. Guarded out there by Colin Moore is back in the game, and now Shep loses the basketball. Moore brings it up to Toppin in transition, blocked, and it goes out of bounds. Moore knocked away than blocked. 5:46 left to go in this first half. Tie game. It'll be Panther basketball on the baseline. And now Justin Roberts is about to come back in, replacing Allen.
Back on that offensive possession by the Charlotte 49ers, two possessions to go. Really liked seeing that, being able to spread the floor there for Jared Garcia, but it's going to see what he can do on the defense end. Can he bring that physicality, that effort that Milos and Anzac Rosetto can?
Roberts out top, left-handed dribble goes left, gives it up to Moore, left corner, three on the way, around the rim, no good. So Simi, the offensive rebound, got it around Garcia, and his foul going back up as he put a move onto the paint. And we'll go to the free throw line for a couple of shots.
And you can see right there, so Sime just taking advantage over Jared Garcia. He just had a little bit, he just had more effort on that. He just wanted that rebound, that offensive rebound more, and that's what Georgia State want. They want to be able to get those second chance opportunities. And you said it perfectly exampled right there from Sime.
First foul on Garcia. The first free throw is no good. Leo Sime went to Cincinnati, University of Cincinnati, before transferring to Atlanta and Georgia State, averaging 16 points a game, almost 8 rebounds a game coming in through the first three. He misses the second free throw as well. Garcia the rebound. Tie game, 23 apiece. Approaching 5 minutes left in this first half at Halton Arena. Niners' second game of the season, looking for their first win. Garcia at the high post, guarded by Sime. Garcia, one dribble, picks it up now, needs some help. Looking, good bounce pass to Young on the baseline. In traffic, shot is up, altered, no good, no foul. Rebound Georgia State. And now Moore, far sideline, brings it up the floor. Moore goes baseline, gets it back outside to Roberts. Under 5 to go, deep straightaway 3 for Roberts, and it's no good. On the rebound, it's batted around, it's on the floor, run down by Georgia State, but then losing the ball is Johnson. Here comes Bryce Williams down the floor, running layup, no good. Follow with the putback is Jameer Young, and the Niners have the lead 25-23.
And love to see right there, that right there for the Charlotte 49ers. They're two young gun sophomores able to run the floor and be able to pick up from wherever Bryce Williams left off. Did Jameer Young. Love whenever you see his aggression going up and being able to finish up there at the rim.
Roberts dribbles left, finds Johnson in the corner for three. He knocks it down. Evan Johnson, the freshman from Durham, came in shooting 42% from the three-point line. That's his first made three tonight. That puts the Panthers back on top by one, 26-25.
Georgia State and their head coach, Lanier, he's got to love being able to bring off a guy who was the number 14 player in Virginia who went to Oak Hill as well off his bench. That's a nice security blanket for sure for Lanier.
Garcia picks his dribble up on the left wing. Now out top it goes to Young. Shot clock at eight. Game clock under four to go in the first half. There's a whistle away from the basket. And it's going to be on Georgia State. I think it's going to be Toppin. It is on JoJo Toppin, his first, the redshirt sophomore from Brooklyn. He was tangled up with Garcia. It'll take us to a timeout. That is team foul number five on the Panthers, so it'll be out of bounds. Niners when we come back. 3:43 left in the first half. 26-25 Georgia State. This is Charlotte Basketball from Learfield, IMG College.
Hey, Harris Teeter shoppers. It's easy to save on fuel with Harris Teeter.
Inside of 4 minutes to go in this first half. It is 26-25 right now. Georgia State on the road with the lead. When you need something these days, you go online and hunt for the very best. When it comes to finding the best health care, the choice is clear. Atrium Health, the only health system in the region nationally ranked by U.S. News and World Report. Learn more at atriumhealth.org/best. Jackson Threadgill back on the floor now of the Niners with Young, Williams, Shepard, and Supica. So Garcia goes out. Inbounds to Bryce Williams out top. Lets the defense fly by. Three-pointer, got it! Nice job by the sophomore Bryce Williams. Let the defender fly by. Went right back up and knocks down the triple.
And it's going to be his second three. He was 1-for-4 in that first game after he knocked down 9-of-30 this past season. Love to see him being aggressive already for the Niners.
Johnson on the right. He'll take a deep shot. No good. Would have been a three. Here come the Niners. Jameer Young comes out of the pack of the ball, racing down the floor, knocked away out of bounds. It'll be Charlotte basketball. The Georgia State bench saying it should be Panther ball, but the officials don't agree.
I don't know if we're going to show that replay or not, but nonetheless, it looked like it might have gone off on Jameer Young, but I know Shep and the rest of the guys, they said, you know what, we'll go ahead and take that. There we go. They cut that replay. I think it was a good thing right there. but hey, nonetheless, hey, another possession here for the Charlotte 49ers. Again, you don't want to exactly make that pace yours if you're Charlotte and Jameer Young. He didn't have the numbers. He was pushing the envelope, but hey, fresh shot clock right here.
Niners lead by a bucket. Jameer on the left wing. Now Shepard out top. The elbow floater. More of a pass, I think, to Milos, who's able to catch it in the paint, put it up, and he scores. I think that was a pass. What do you think?
If it wasn't a pass, it wasn't a very good shot. It was probably his worst floater, and he works on that more than anybody, that floater. So I'm really hoping that was not.
And here's a carry out top by Roberts of Georgia State. He turns the ball right back over to the 49ers. You know, Georgia State coming in has been a team that turns over their opponents quite a bit, almost 18 a game. The Niners in Atlanta last year turned it over a lot in that overtime loss to Georgia State. Now, so far today, both teams with four turnovers, so that's not been a factor right now. 2:47 to go in this first half. The Niners by four.
Yeah, Matt, it was, 19 turnovers, I believe, in that game in Atlanta, the overtime win for the Panthers last season.
Jackson Threadgill goes left. Gives it up, gets it right back, baseline, short, mid-range jumper, about 10, 11 feet, he knocks it down.
Just love the poise, I love the confidence, everything I see from 12 in white for the Charlotte 49ers.
Williams driving, bumped by Shepard, there's a whistle and a foul on Jordan Shepard of the 49ers. And that's going to be Shep's first. Couple of free throws coming here for Williams.
A little continuation right there, maybe. It looked like he got it before he was picking the ball up to go into the shot.
Niners on a 7-0 run. Last 1:23, they made four of the last five shots from the floor. And the free throw here by Kane Williams is good. That'll end the 7-0 run. So Williams, now 4 of 5 at the free throw line tonight. Remember, he came in 1 for 12. So quite an improvement so far in the first half tonight. Makes them both. It's now a four-point game, 32-28. Threadgill's going to throw it in bounds for the Niners. Full court man-to-man for the Panthers. Young in the backcourt. He'll bring it up as Roberts backs away. Approaching 2 minutes to play in this opening half. Niners by four. Williams to Threadgill. Behind the arc on the left. Now back to Bryce on the right side. He'll launch one. Back rim, no good. Deep jumper doesn't drop. Here comes Williams the other way. Williams gets down the lane. Gives it up in the right corner. Here's a step back three, no good, rebound tip, picked up by the Niners. Shepard gives it up to Young, he'll drive, goes for the dunk, and he's fouled by Roberts. Jameer Young showing that he can get up there. He went for the right-hand windmill. He'll go back to the free throw line.
Again, I love making a statement right there for Jameer Young as you check on the replay, going up strong with the right hand. It's the left-handed guard for the Niners, but again, he can finish with either the left or the right hand. Really good on those putback dunks, and that's why you work on it before and after practice, because I don't know if Sanchez lets him do that during practice.
Second foul on Roberts. The free throw is good by Young. One more coming. Niners right now leading by five. Back in the game, Evan Johnson replacing Roberts. They don't want him to pick up a third foul in the final 2 minutes. The first half, the Niners have held Georgia State to 33% shooting from the floor, while Charlotte has hit 50% of their shots. Second free throw is also good for Jameer Young. Niners have equaled their six-point lead, 34-28. Toppin gives it back out to Williams, out between the circles, guarded by Young, gets a screen, goes through a double team, gives it up, Toppin underneath, reverse layup is good. 34-30, Niners with the lead. Now they quickly get it up the floor into the front court. And Young gives it back to Jordan Shepard, who hands it right back to Jameer. 19 to shoot, 1:15 to play. Charlotte by four. Threadgill now to Shepard. He'll drive right to the hoop. Contact, no foul, no whistle. Missed the shot. Here comes Georgia State. 3-on-1 and a alley-oop lay-in for Toppin. Now it's a two-point game, and Ron Sanchez wants a timeout.
It looks like he wants a timeout. Not very happy with the officials as well. And that no call on the other end there from George Shepard.
A lot of contact. They let him play through it. Ends up a fast break on the other side. That's one thing the Niners have been able to limit Georgia State's success with here in the first half, those fast break runouts. Although Georgia State still has 7 points off the break. 58.3 seconds to go in this first half. Charlotte 34 and Georgia State 32. Today's game brought to you by Ortho Carolina. When you're choosing Ortho, you're choosing a nationally recognized leader in orthopedic care. Their providers have decades of experience in the muscles, research, diagnosis, and treatment of conditions affecting your muscles, bones, and joints. More than 160 physicians at over 40 locations throughout the Carolinas. Ortho Carolina is your destination for orthopedic excellence and care and service, one patient at a time. Ortho Carolina, you improved. Threadgill to throw it in. This time the Panthers don't have anybody in the backcourt. Niners will bring it up the floor. Shep walks it across the half-court line. Panthers back into a man-to-man. Shot clock at 15 seconds. Game clock at 42 seconds right now. Young on the right, looking for Milos. Gets it to Threadgill out top. Shot clock at 6. Now Shepard. He'll drive, get low. Scoop shot off the glass. He scores. Nice finish by Jordan Shepard. And now Coach Lanier wants a timeout for Georgia State to set up their last possession. 30.5 seconds on the clock. There's plenty of time. Can run the whole offense with the full 30-second shot clock right here, Trevor.
Yeah, exactly. But is that what they want to do, Matt? Because if you think about it, do they ever want to take away 30 seconds? And so that's a good thing for the Niners. They've been playing the way that Charlotte wants to play on the offense end. Heck, even on the defensive end as well. They're creating very tough shots for Georgia State. They're going to make some shots. And, of course, they're up at 32 points. Right now the Niners will take that on average just around that 60-point mark. That, hey, if the game's in the 60s, Matt, that's exactly where Charlotte thinks that they can win this ball game, is that they can keep it there. And again, loving the pace on the offense end for the Niners and loving what they're doing to Georgia State. They're making them take very highly contested shots, and let's see if they take all 30 seconds.
16 of the Niners' 36 points here in the first half have been points in the paint. They've been able to get to the rim just like Shepard did a moment ago. Shepard with 8 points. Jameer Young, the game's high scorer, has 11. And Kane Williams for Georgia State has 10. Came into the game averaging just under 14 a game. Now Williams just across that half-court line is going to dribble for a bit, work that clock. It's down to 10.
No one is moving.
And here they go. He goes towards the left side, guarded by Jameer Young. Out top to Allen. Shot clock, game clock down to 2 seconds. A three on the way, no good. And we have reached halftime here at Halton Arena with the 49ers on top of Georgia State. The score is 36-32. And a good first half for the 49ers. They hold Georgia State to 37% shooting in this opening 20 minutes here tonight.
Yeah, love to see that again. Defense, offense, both clicking. They're playing the pace, exact opposite of what happened in that first half at Georgia State in Atlanta just about a year ago today, Matt. So yeah, loving what you're seeing by the Charlotte 49ers, able to protect the basketball only with 4 turnovers. They've only caused 4 turnovers, but it doesn't matter. They only have 4 turnovers on their side of the ball, so they're loving what they're seeing. It's going to be a lot happier of a talking to the boys, except for whenever they played ECU this past week.
A lot of balance through the Niners offense as well. Everybody has scored except for Jared Garcia, who's missed his one shot but does have a couple of rebounds coming off the bench, seeing his first time as a Niner. at the break on top 36-32. Man, I feel like a new guy right now, Trevor.
you got the mask on.
I've gone through three masks in the first half, and I've gone face shield. You were so kind to go find me a face shield, and it feels like it's a whole new season.
You look like a bad man. That's what I'm saying. You look like a bad – you're a bad mamma jamma right now. But, guys, hey, also bad mamma jamma, the defense for the Charlotte 49ers. Holding Georgia State to 37%. It's like they have a face shield on. I was making the I was making this funny remark before the game, Matt, with someone. It might have been Brent or Sam, the photographer, saying, I know this whole 6 feet thing, but I hope that the Charlotte 49ers, they don't give up less than 6 inches when it comes to them guarding Georgia State. And by the score, I know it's only a four-point lead for them, but that's exactly where they won them in the first half. And I think that was probably a good halftime probably speech right there from Sanchez saying, hey, boys, let's keep it up. We're making them grind for every single bucket.
Good first half for Jameer Young. He led the Niners with 11 points, going 3 of 6 from the floor, made a 3, was 4 of 6 to the foul line, plus he had 3 rebounds and 3 assists. Jordan Shepherd, 8 points, made a couple of 3s. Milo Supica, 4 points, 3 rebounds. Bryce Williams, a good first half, 5 points and a team-high 5 rebounds, Trevor.
Yeah, and I'd love to see what I love what you're seeing from Bryce Williams. And we saw this last year. Remember, Matt, it was the first game against James Madison. He came out and knocked down like 3 threes, had 11 points, and we're like, oh, yeah, this is the Bryce Williams that we all knew we were getting from nearby Hopewell High School. And then the rest of the season, it became just too sporadic, him coming into the ball game. But love to see whenever he's in there for 20, 25 minutes a game, a larger sample size, and this kid is really showing why he picked here, and really a good providing some clarity and some beautiful recognition to his father and Henry Williams.
Points off the paint, the Niners 16, Georgia State had 10 in the paint in the first half. I also noticed that Jerry Matos, who started the game, did not really play much in the second part of the first half.
Yeah, foul trouble. That's exactly what got to him. He picked up 2 fouls in the first, I think it was 6 minutes of the ballgame, maybe 7 minutes of the ballgame. So, again, doing all this without him, Shep was able to get some good breather as well. Yeah, of course, Jameer Young playing a little bit more minutes than you exactly expect. But, hey, he loves to be out there for 35 minutes of ballgame. He can do it. Bryce Williams stepping up, Garcia and Zach Rosetto. Matt, they got 9 deep right now, and they're confident with all 9 guys.
Kane Williams, the leading scorer for Georgia State in the first half. He had 10 points, and a guy was 1 of 12 at the foul line coming into the game. Made 5 of 6 free throw attempts in the first half. Also chipped in with 3 rebounds and a couple of assists in the first 20 minutes as well. Roberts, who is their leading scorer, 19.7 a game coming in. Only 3 points. He made a 3-pointer. He was 1 of 3, all 3-point shots in the first 20 minutes. The Niners held Georgia State to 37% in the first half from the floor. Niners at 50% in the first half from the floor. And I just realized what I didn't do here, Trev. I didn't take our last halftime break.
I was waiting for you to do it.
I'm telling you, man. It's I'm thrown off. I'm thrown off my game right now. The face shield's helping, but my mind was thinking it was taking it down to 0 for the start of the game, not going to break with 2 minutes to go. So Mario Washington back in the studio. I apologize. At some point, we got to get an extra break in. We'll figure that out.
Guys, this is what I have to work with.
It's a work in progress.
Game.
I'm really not very good.
I mean, the mortician over there, I mean, he's 20 years in. And then, I'm sorry, Mario. We still
love
you back.
There's a lot going on. There's a lot going on right now. And none of it is good. So.
You got Les over here, one of the most historic refs that you'll find in college basketball. Him and Jameer Young kind of going at it right now with this rap song. And cool thing, hey, Jameer Young, his I think it's his uncle or cousin, is Dave East. He's one of the best rappers you'll find. So, guys, Jameer Young, I think it's uncle, Dave East.
Oh, yeah, he's one of my favorites.
I follow him now. I follow him for the last year. He's great, man. And the guy can hoop. He actually hooped with Kevin Durant up in D.C. Oh, I've studied this guy. I know a lot about him.
It is officially off the rails now.
Oh, here we go. Hey, let's play second half basketball.
You know, if they're going to wait anymore, I could have got that last break in.
Les is laughing at you right now.
It's going to be Niner ball to begin the second half. There's something going on the scores table. That's what the issue is. And I'm not sure if it's going to be long enough to get this break in. Nope, the official's saying nope, get back on the floor.
Sorry, Mario.
I was thinking if there was some kind of technical difficulty there on the scorer's table, we might have been able to get that break in. So it's going to be Supica, Matos, Bryce Williams, Shepard, and Young. Same starting five will begin this second half of the Niners. They'll be going from right to left on the floor here at Halton in the second half. And they put it in play. Shepard in the backcourt is going to get it across that half-court line. Right-handed dribble gives it up out top to Bryce Williams. Bounce pass to Matos. Top of the key. Now Milos in the right. He'll drive, give it up on the wing. Shepard has it. 17 to shoot. Back out to Young. Now to Milos out top. Milos holding on to it. Looking across the floor. Finds Bryce Williams. He's open. Takes a three. It's around the rim. No good. Rebound Georgia State. Here come the Panthers. Niners lead by four. 36 to 32. Allen's going to lob it. Looking for Sosime. Tipped away. And in the hands of Boyce on the baseline. He gets it out to Roberts. Justin Roberts. Back over to Boyce on the wing. One dribble, picks it up, gets it out top. They're working left over to Allen. Guarded by Matos out there. There's a screen by Sosime, driving and shooting a floater. No good. Allen missing. Here come the Niners the other way. Young to the bucket. Scores. He had given it up to Shep, but it hit Shep in the shoulder. Young picked it right back up. Never broke stride and able to finish with the layup.
Wow, his maturity, his body control. Matt, he went up, he thought he was going to pass halfway, ended up, instead of going for the pass, went up for the shot himself after drawing contact. Kid is so good.
Allen out top, so Simi down low, around Supica off the glass and in. They were looking for the and one, didn't get the whistle. Niners again by four, 38-34. Just over a minute into the second half here at Halton Arena. Charlotte still at 50% from the floor for the game. Shepard front court on the left. Bounce pass to Milos out top. Head of the circle. One dribble. Picks it up. Looking for help. Young popping out. Ball knocked away, though. So Simi comes away with it. Now to Roberts. He'll drive. Blocked away by Shepard. So Simi the rebound. Left hand up. No good. Ball loose in the hands of Roberts for Georgia State. Another chance here. Williams going to take a three. Makes it. Lefty from the right side makes the three. 2 minutes into the second half. It's a one-point Niner lead. 38-37. 30-second timeout taken by Ron Sanchez. It'll be stretched to a full, so we'll step aside. This is Charlotte basketball from Learfield IMG College.
Hey, Harris.
Start with a foundation of toughness, then add exceptional intelligence and dominating power. That's how you build a winner. And that's how Ford builds their lineup of vehicles with features like EcoBoost technology for a winning combination of power and performance. Another reason why Ford is America's best-selling brand 10 years in a row. Leaders aren't born, they're built. And in the Carolinas, they're built for victory. Learn more at buyfordnow.com or contact your Carolina Ford dealer today. Based on 2010 through 2019 calendar year sales.
Now, coming out of break, the Niners had a possession, missed a three-pointer. Jameer Young missing it from that left side. So Georgia State with the ball. They trail by one, 17-26 remaining in the game. Here's a three in the right corner, missed. The rebound of Young. The three missed by Corey Allen. Niners running out. Bryce Williams down the floor, has it blocked away. but it goes out of bounds off of Williams of the Panthers. It'll be Charlotte basketball on the end line, 17-16 to play in the game.
And he had Jordan Shepherd, did Bryce Williams. He had him up available for that lob to his right side. You know, Shep was about to start jumping. He was licking his chops waiting for that ball from Bryce.
Shep throws it inbounds to Bryce Williams. Outside it goes to Young. Goes left. Now to Rosetto out top. Anzac had a basket in the first half, couple of rebounds as well. Shep's going to back it back out. Shep on the right side behind the arc, 10 to shoot, steps back, takes the three. It's off the iron, no good. On the rebound, Georgia State saves it on the end line. Panthers down one, can take the lead with a basket. 3 minutes gone by here in the second half. This is the 30th meeting all time between Charlotte and Georgia State. The Panthers winning in overtime in Atlanta last year. Williams taking a three, and he makes it. There was some contact on the shot, too. Matos knocking him down, but no whistle. Could have been a chance at a four-point play. It puts the Panthers on top by two. Young down the lane, missing the runner, though. Couldn't finish with the left-handed layup attempt off the glass. Georgia State running out. Roberts for three. No good. Rebound Charlotte. Matos clears the miss away. And the Niners don't want to get into an up-and-down battle here in the second half. That kind of plays into Georgia State's way of wanting to play.
That's exactly Ron Sanchez. He goes slow as soon as Jameer Young ended up picking up that rebound.
Shep out top. He'll drive again. Double pump shot. No good. Rebound to Rosetto, though. Back out to Young for three. That's down and out. Bryce Williams the rebound. Puts it up and he's fouled in the paint. And free throws coming for Bryce Williams. The fouls on Justin Roberts, I believe. Or is it Ryan Boyce? It's Ryan Boyce. That'll be his second. Time out of the floor, 16 minutes or 15:51 to go in the second half. Just under the 16 mark, so immediate timeout. Georgia State 40, Charlotte 38. This is Niner basketball from Learfield, IMG College. first free throw is good by Shep. One more now coming for Jordan Shepherd. Niners lead by 141-40. Williams goes out of the game for Georgia State. Roberts back on the floor now. Second free throw is also good. And now Jackson Threntgill is going to come in replacing Bryce Williams for the Niners. Niners by two, 15 minutes to play here in the second half at Halton Arena. 30th meeting all time, Charlotte, Georgia State. Roberts will step out, shoot a three, no good. Rebound Niners, Shepherd's got it. He'll bring it up the floor himself with Toppin on his backside. Able to get around Toppin and get it to Young. Jameer, a couple of dribbles and a handoff to Matos. They work it now to the right. Shep with it. Bounce pass to Matos. Baseline right. Skips it across the floor. Young's open. Takes the three. That's no good. Rebound Toppin for Georgia State. And he's going to be fouled by Rosetto. They say Rosetto is kind of bodying up on Toppin to push him towards the baseline. And that's the third foul on Anzac Rosetto for the 49ers.
Yeah, a little overzealous right there was Anzac. And he'll now say a couple choice words to himself as he exits and Milos comes in, but still again, love the tenacity, love the effort right there. Just a little overzealous as he was kind of riding top and just to that out-of-bound marker. But again, loving the way that Jordan Shepherd and Jameer Young are slowing down the offense for the Niners and playing into the pace that Georgia State does not want to on the defense end. And same thing right now for the Niners on the defense end, getting late in the shot clock for Georgia State.
Panthers have it 15 to shoot. Into the left corner it goes. Johnson now to Toppin at the elbow. Toppin spinning around Matos. Offensive foul clearing out with his right arm. And that'll be Toppin's second personal foul. He clears out Matos and right in front of one of the baseline officials.
Looks like a full court press right now going on for Georgia State. They've been doing that throughout the ball game, but it hasn't been too intense. As intense as that, it probably will end up kind of getting to over here the second half of the second half.
Matos in the front court now gets it to Threadgill. Out beyond the top of the key. Bounce pass to Shepherd. Now to the free throw line. Finds Supica. Goes up the dunk. Blocked away. And here comes Georgia State. Colin Moore blocking that from behind. He'll find Roberts, who goes to the right side. In the corner. Backs it out on the wing. Threadgill guarding him. The Niners got back defensively. Now Roberts goes baseline. Finds top in the lane. And a foul on the 49ers. Toppin was a little bit out of control, but he had one of the 49ers backpedaling and picks up the foul. And now free throws coming for JoJo Toppin. Foul's going to be on Matos, his third. So he has three and Rosetto has three. The two Niners in foul trouble. And Bryce Williams will check back in the game at the next opportunity. Toppin 38% so far this season in the line. And the first shot is up and good.
And back on the other side, Ron Sanchez, I don't know if the camera caught it or not, but Ron Sanchez, he was absolutely livid. I think he just wanted Milos to go up with the left hand and just kiss it off the glass over a couple defenders. And instead of that poster, that attempt of a poster dunk over three guys, it's so much easier right now just to get that easy basket. We would love just to see him lay it in and get those easy 2 points.
One more free throw now for Toppin. And a lot of movement in the line, but no violation since he made the shot. Niners had jumped early. So it's 42-42, Toppin making both free throws. And, you know, the Panthers as a team coming into the first three games shooting 58% at the free throw line. So far tonight, 75% making 9 of 12. Game tied at 42, 13-29 to play. Threadgill out top of the ball, picks his dribble up, guarded by Roberts. Out of Supica, left of the lane, guarded by Sosimi, trying to back him down. Goes right hand, lost the ball going up, and Georgia State comes away with it. Moore brings it ahead, goes around his back, drives, goes right, finds Toppin for the lay-in. And now Georgia State by two with the fast break basket. It's now 44-42.
Yeah, now you got the energy, the bench for Georgia State. They're all standing up, and either Shep, he looks like he either wanted a timeout or just saying, hey, let's slow things down real quick and get the ball into our playmakers' hands. Shep and Jameer Young.
Shepherd drives the lane, goes left hand off the glass, comes up short. Rebound of Moore for Georgia State. Shep had a good look. Topping down the floor, left-handed slam as they run the break, and he throws the dunk down to give the Panthers a four-point lead. The timeout called by Coach Sanchez. It's 46-42 with 12:40 left to go here in the ballgame.
Well, that's exactly what Georgia State wants. It looks like it just will stay as a 30-second timeout as well. Can get the ball out there to Toppin. And JoJo Toppin, the redshirt sophomore from Brooklyn. Again, he's that transfer from Georgia. A few transfer for him. They got Georgia transfer, Detroit transfers as well, and Memphis transfers. They're all over the place. They have four-star recruits. Georgia State, they have a very talented team. Again, it wasn't a fluke whenever they beat Georgia State in that home opener, 123-120 in that 4-OT. This team can score, this team can play, and they're not going to be a team that's going to go away easily and with any ease for sure. And Sanchez is probably saying that right now. Boys, if you thought this was going to be a cakewalk here in the second half, they were going to roll over, that's not what they're about. Georgia State, they're going to bring that energy. They're going to still want to go ahead and score 80. Try to get up to that 80, that 90 part. And they're showing it over the last two or three minutes. And look, they're saying, hey, let's keep talking on the bench. It's Georgia State. The Niners, they got to find something. It looks like they're going to bring it in. Zach Rosetto here for Milo Supica.
Well, the Panthers have a four-point lead, their biggest lead of the game. A little bit of pressure in the backcourt. Niners get the ball in bounds. Young, he'll bring it ahead. Guarded by Johnson, gets around Bryce Williams into the front court. Now Bryce with the ball, over to Shepard. Shepard on the left side, dribbles out. Shot clock at 14. Niners have gone one of their last 11 from the floor. And here's a foul and a drive by Jameer Young. It's going to be on Georgia State. As Jameer put it on the floor on the right side, the foul's going to be on Evan Johnson. That'll be his first, team's fourth. Out of bounds, Niners on the baseline. Shep's going to throw it in bounds to the right of the Niner basket. Shep has to hurry, gets it to Bryce Williams along the baseline. Now back outside it goes. Threadgill left the key. He's guarded by Roberts. Gives it to Bryce Williams. Bryce on the left side. On top it goes to Shep. They work it back to Threadgill, right of the key this time. The freshman out of Davidson Day. Shot clock at four. Bryce Williams stepped back in left corner. Three. Got it. Big shot for Bryce Williams. The Niners needed that after going one of their last 11. It's now 46-45 Georgia State. Bryce has made a couple of threes.
Yeah, he loves that step back three on that that far corner, does Bryce Williams.
There's a missed jumper by Roberts. Niners the rebound. Rosetto clearing it away. Now Jameer Young driving. You'll find Threadgill left corner, and he was on the end line, or on the sideline, I should say.
There's a timeout on the
floor. And the Niners turned the ball over as he was kind of setting up to shoot. His foot was out of bounds. 11:38 to go in the ballgame. Timeout on the floor. Georgia State 46, the 49ers 45. This is Niner basketball from Learfield, IMG College. University Eye Associates have provided vision care to the Charlotte 49ers student athletes, coaches, and fans. See University Eye Associates for all your eye care needs. University Eye, excellence in eye care. Out of the timeout, Georgia State ball. 11:35 to go now. And the Panthers on the road with a one-point lead, 46-45. Panthers in the front court. Allen back on the floor. Finds Osimi. Bounce pass right corner. Moore for three. That's no good. On the rebound, Osimi over the back, but no call. Then he shuffles his feet, gets called for a walk. There's a couple of times where he's got a rebound, and it looked like he's climbed the back of a 49er, but he's gotten away with it. That time after the no call, he gets called for a walk.
Yeah, so Semi, I mean, he's just at 6'9", but he looks so much bigger out there on the court, especially the way that he can sky through the gym. And again, big physical body, that's what he wants to bring to Anzac Rosetto.
Long arms, the Cincinnati transfer. Niners bring some pressure in the backcourt. 19 to shoot. Now a pass stolen away as Williams takes that pass intended for Bryce Williams away. Missed the runner, though, and the rebound cleared and put back in by Brian Boyce of Georgia State. Their lead is back to three. Niners have not been hurt by turnovers much here today. Now they can't get the ball in bounds, and Shepard has to call a timeout. 30-second timeout. That's going to be stretched to a full timeout. There's 10:52 to play in the second half. So we'll step aside for this timeout. Georgia State 48 and the Niners 45. This is Charlotte basketball from Learfield IMG College.
It's bow time.
There's a liner here.
Charlotte Bath by Progressive's Home Insurance. Get your quote at progressive.com today.
Go. Hey, welcome back. Niners breaking some pressure in the backcourt. They trail by three. 10.5 to go. Bryce Williams pump fake goes baseline. Floating shot is off the rim and no good. And the rebound of the Panthers of Georgia State. Panthers by three right now. Williams brings it up ahead. Now to Moore on the left. 4-3. No good. Rebound Charlotte. Young clearing it away. Now Jameer gets it to Shepard on the left side. Shep in the front court. Goes towards the baseline. Now in the corner. Looks inside for Rosetto. Turns. Goes for the shot. He's fouled from behind. He spun. He was wide open. Then Moore came from behind and blocked the shot away. But picks up the personal foul. And that's going to send Anzac Rosetto to the free throw line for a couple of shots with 10:07 to play in the game. And the Niners down three right now.
And we know Matos, it looked like he was on that far corner, that far side. He was waiting for that swing to him from Anzac Rosetto, who knocks down that first free throw.
The first one good. One more for the sophomore from Auckland, New Zealand. Niners trail by two, and now make it one as Rosetto makes them both. He was perfect on that one. 48-47, Georgia State. Now the Niners, who were shooting 50% at halftime, down to 40% for the game. So it's been a much rockier shooting second half of the Niners so far. Allen out top, trying to get around Rosetto. Good job by Anzac not to commit the foul. Allen gets it back, takes a three, misses. Good defense by the Niners, and a foul now. It's going to be on Allen, and they might have called an intentional foul on Allen for grabbing Matos.
They did. I believe so. Yeah, they did.
First foul on Allen, team six, and it's an intentional foul, so we'd get free throws, and it'd be Matos shooting the free throws, and then the 49ers would get the ball back. It's been a while, actually, before we've seen, since we've seen the intentional foul called, first time this year, and Matos to go to the line. The graduate senior transfer makes the first. That ties the game at 48 with 9:45 to play. One more free throw for Jerry. And he's got it. Now the Niners on a little bit of a run. They were down here in the second half by four. And now they're up by one.
Yeah, he's got wonderful touch, wonderful feel, does Matos. It just looks so effortless off those fingers, even with the free throws and those fadeaway jumpers late in the shot clock. Look to him to have the ball in his hands as well, working with Shep and Young here over the last 9 minutes and 35 seconds.
Niners get possession back, but Jameer Young driving the lane, lost the handle. He was trying to get rid of the ball, but it was knocked back at him, and then he lost it. So here comes Georgia State in the corner. With the ball as Boyce gets it back outside. Williams with it out top, guarded by Jameer Young. Goes left down the lane, gives it to Sosimi, who missed the shot. Boyce the follow, no good. Rebound Matos for the Niners, who lead by one. 9 minutes to play. Shepard in the front court, he'll drive, kick it out. They work into the right corner. Bryce Williams, he's going to drive, and he's fouled. He went for the dunk, and he was fouled by Corey Allen, who gets his second personal foul, and two free throws coming for Bryce Williams. Good ball movement that time by Charlotte.
Yeah, wonderful ball movement right there. They passed up the open shot, did Jameer Young for a more open shot, as he even had the pump fake there, which Bryce Williams, that's one of his go-to moves, loves the pump fake, loves to drive baseline, did exactly that. And again, on that one-on-one, you know you're going to get fouled. That's whenever you go up for the dunk. You don't try to go finesse shot there. You go up for the dunk, and that's exactly what the sophomore did right there for the Niners.
First free throw is good for Bryce. Bryce now with 9 points. Last season, his best scoring game was 11 against James Madison. So one more now for Bryce, trying to get into double figures. Niners by two. And this one is off the back of the rim, no good. Rebound at Toppin for Georgia State, who just came back in the game. Also back on the floor is Caleb Scott for Georgia State. Roberts back out there as well. Roberts out top, getting a screen, goes right down the lane. Good defense, ball knocked away. Roberts gets it back. On the right side, 12 to shoot, will back it out, reset the offense. Now driving left, pulls up in the lane, gets it back out of the right wing. On the baseline, Allen gives it up. Now Williams has it blocked from Shepard, or by Shepard. Now to Jameer Young, running out for the layup. Nice job, the defense getting the turnover, then a fantastic fast break. On the other end, though, Allen answers quickly. Mid-range jumper right of the lane, 52-50, Niners by two.
I mean, Matt, look how quick that was. They scored within 3 seconds of the shot clock. It was an absolute Hail Mary pass, goes up, gets two dribbles in, knocks it right in, 3-4 seconds in. But again, wonderful offense over the last four or five appearances down on the left side of the court right here at Halton Arena for the Charlotte 49ers.
Under eight to go, and Jameer Young looking for Anzac Rosetto, threw it behind him. The Niners turn the ball over. Georgia State can tie with a two, and Rosetto's going to foul Toppin, which will be Anzac Rosetto's fourth foul. And JoJo Toppin's going to go to the line for a couple of shots to potentially tie this game. 7:49 left here in the second half at Halton Arena. Timeout on the floor, 52-50. The Niners on top of Georgia State. This is Charlotte basketball from Learfield IMG College.
When you need it.
Harris Teeter, no matter how you celebrate, it's all about the food. Delicious subs and wraps, fresh hot store-made pizza. Ready to serve wing trays and lots more. Plus, with Harris Teeter's fuel points, you can earn free fuel with every purchase up to $1 off per gallon. Harris Teeter, where Niner fans shop for groceries. So JoJo Tappan's going to be at the free throw line. A couple of shots coming. Milo Supica back on the floor for the Niners with Shepard, Matos, Bryce Williams, and Jameer Young out of the timeout. Tappan's a lefty, and the first free throw is good. So the Niners' lead is now 1-52-51, 7:49 left to go in regulation. These two teams played overtime a year ago, and Georgia State won the overtime game in Atlanta. It was 81-78 that night. Second free throw is good. Tie game 52 apiece. Full court man-to-man. Young gets it across the half-court line. Out of Matos on the right. Shepard out top over to Milos. Right side. Hands it off. Shepard finds Young. Left corner. He's open. Takes the three. Buries it. Boy, the Niners would love to see Jameer Young get hot in the closing 7.5 minutes. Lead is now 3 again for Charlotte.
And now 18 points here for Jameer Young. Again, the star sophomore for the Niners.
Williams finds Toppin on the baseline. Allen, left corner three, answers and ties the game at 55 as we go back and forth here in the second half at Halton Arena.
Again, don't exactly want to go back and forth with the Niners. I mean, heck, you'll trade some threes as long as you're making them. But again, slowing the pace down, getting to your offense and pushing it whenever you need be it. Again, that's whenever Jameer Young plays best.
Supica out top, one dribble. Gives it up now to Young on the right. He'll dribble out, find Matos, left corner. Matos spins, almost stepped out of bounds, but lost the dribble anyway. And here comes Georgia State. They can take the lead with the bucket. Johnson to Toppin, and Toppin travels out high, trying to put a move on before he put the ball on the deck. He dragged his foot, and the Niners get the gift and the ball right back.
And Matt, whenever you said that Matos almost stepped out, Les Jones, he looked down, he goes, you could tell he was thinking, he goes, yeah, he definitely just stepped out, but I didn't call it fast enough, so I'm not going to call it. That's exactly what happened.
It looked like he might have stepped out from here.
He played the advantage right there, that you're supposed to play in soccer. Well, he played the advantage here in basketball.
Jackson Threadgill coming in, giving Jameer Young a breather with 6:36 to go. He won't be on the bench for long.
Yeah.
Just getting a breather. 6.5 to go here at Halton, 55 apiece. Supica, right of the key, guarded by Sosimi out there. Out to Shepard. They switch off, Sosimi's on him to Threadgill in the corner. Back out to Williams, shot clock at 10. Matos, right of the key. Williams on him, goes baseline, pulls up mid-range, knocking it down. He loves that shot from 10, 11 feet. And the Niners lead by 2 once again.
And a mid-range shot able to come up, that little pull-up. He gets a lot of arc and a lot of jump on his jumpers.
Allen for 3 in the lead. He knocks it down on the right side. It's now 58-57. Allen's made a couple of threes here in the second half. He now has 11. One of 3 Panthers in double figures tonight. Approaching 5.5 to play here in regulation. Bryce Williams on the left, guarded by JoJo Toppin. Out of Milos out high. Milos dribbles towards the right side, hands it to Shepard. Shepard in the lane, has it knocked away from behind, but a foul reaching in committed by Evan Johnson, which will be his second. 8 on the team, a 1-1. Opportunity now for Jordan Shepard. And tonight he's 2 of 2 at the line. The Niners 11 of 16, 69% as the team at the free throw line tonight. Georgia State 11 of 14, 79%. Free throw is good. The net almost didn't move. It was perfect.
Yeah, going to need these shots right now for the Niners. Again, Georgia State, they want to get those early, not just early shots in their offense, but they want to get those early steals as well so they're able to jump up in that high-power offense. And they're going to have some of those whenever they're going to stick the hand in the cookie jar, come up with some forearms. That's exactly what Jordan Shepherd did right there, able to knock down a couple shots.
Takes it both. Niners back in front. It's the 14th lead change in the game tonight. 5:20 left to play. Topping at the top of the key, gives it up left side. Williams for 3, makes it. Big 3 deep in that left corner, and now it's a 61-59 lead for Georgia State. The 15th lead change here tonight. Shepard dribbling on the left, backs it out, guarded by Williams. Bounce pass to Milos out high. Under 5 minutes to play in regulation. Now Jameer Young is back in the game. He came in during that last dead ball. Here's a drive by Shep down the lane. Missed the shot, though. And the rebound at Toppin for Georgia State. They've got the ball leading by two. Williams driving. Tough shot. Lost the ball. Missed the shot. Rebound to Matos. Boy, as tough as Shepard's shot was in traffic, Williams was even tougher. And now Matos losing the handle in the hands of Georgia State as Johnson comes away with it. Now Matos trailing the play, couldn't get out of the way of Johnson and runs the smaller player over and picks up his fourth foul. He didn't want to do that. He was trying not to run him over, but that's now four fouls on Matos, four fouls on the 49ers here in the second half.
Yeah, just not a smart play right there for Matos. He knows that that's exactly what Evan Johnson's going to do. And I mean, he's a guard himself, and knowing that's exactly, he's just going to draw that stupid contact.
So Simi inside missing the runner, but it's tipped in by JoJo Toppin. And the lead is now four once again, equals Georgia State's largest lead with 4:11 to go, 63-59. Niners have the ball. Milos in the front court. Over to Jameer Young. Jameer has it knocked away from behind. That's what Georgia State's been doing a lot here in the second half. Now Allen driving. He loses the handle, but a foul is going to be called on Jordan Shepard of the Niners reaching in. Now Shep's done it a lot, and now Jameer trying to drive the middle of the lane. It's being knocked away from behind by one of the smaller guards. That time, Evan Johnson. So a foul on Shepard will be Georgia State ball. Timeout, 3:55 to go. Right now, 63-59 Panthers. This is Niner basketball from Learfield IMG College. Trail by four, so Georgia State has equaled what has been their biggest lead of the game, 4 points. Caleb Stone Carewell comes on the floor for what I believe is his first time on the floor here in the second half.
Yeah, it definitely is. And we were wondering that through, I think, two or three breaks ago, wondering, hey, where's Caleb Stone Carewell been? And yeah, we liked what we saw from him in the first half. He looked good on the defensive side of the ball.
Inbounds to Allen in the right corner for Georgia State. He'll get it back outside. Out near the center circle, Johnson with the ball guarded by Shepard. Gets it back to Toppin, left the key. Toppin's going to drive, and a foul called on Bryce Williams, who reached for him and grabbed him. That's two on Bryce, six on the team. It'll be out of bounds, Georgia State, 3:44. Left to go on the second half clock here at Halton.
And if you're the Niners on defense, you do like this setup, though, just because you do have them in a half-court offense, and that's exactly what Georgia State doesn't want to do. They want to push the pace.
Johnson out top trying to get by Shepard, splits a double team, finds an open Moore in the right corner for three, throws an air ball, but right in the hands of Toppin. Out to Allen. He'll take a three and make it. And the lead is seven for the first time tonight for the Panthers with 3:22 to go. Niners struggling to get the ball in bounds. They turn it over, and Moore's going to dunk the basketball. Colin Moore, the freshman from Little Rock, Arkansas, makes it now a 9-point Georgia State lead, 68-59.
It looks like they just won it more right now in the second half, Max Swearad, and this is a huge offense possession right now for Jordan Shepherd and the Shaw 49ers. They need a good momentum shot.
Shepherd for three, no good off the back of the rim. Stone Carriwell saves the ball, gets it to Bryce Williams. Shot clock now at 16. Shepherd goes to the right, spins, gets down the lane. They're going to call a foul, not a walk. The Panthers wanted a walk call, but the foul's going to be on Aleel Sosime.
Looks like Shep was trying to take matters into his own hands right there. And look at Ron Sanchez looking up at Stone Carriwell. That's tough. It's tough for Stone Carriwell, Matt, if you think about it. I mean, heck, you don't play. Oh, there we go. He comes out of the ball game, but about to say, you don't play for 18 minutes. You come in for a minute and expected to come right there and comes out of the ball game, and Matos quickly comes back in, trying to stay away from that fifth foul.
Well, the free throw, a 1-1. The first one is no good by Shepherd. Rebound at Georgia State. They get their first double-digit lead with the basket. 2:30 left to go in the game. And a timeout's been called by head coach Ron Lanier of the Panthers, a 30-second timeout. Well, for the game, the Panthers now up to 40% shooting. Better here in the second after a 10-0 run the last 2:45. Niners have turned it over three times in the last 3 minutes. Haven't scored in 3 minutes. And in the second half, the Niners only shooting 30% right now.
And they got 9 turnovers here in the second half to the Niners. And just after having 4 in the first half, and it's 3 for Young. Very uncharacteristic from him. He does have 4 rebounds to go along with 7 points in these 16 minutes. But a plus-minus is minus 13 for Jameer Young right now here in just the second half. Two turnovers for Matos as well. He got 1 for Supico, 1 for Shep, 1 for Carriwell, and 1 for Threadgill as well. So, yeah, not making it easy on themselves right now. The Niners here in the second half, 2:30 to go. And they got themselves a hole to dig themselves out of against a high-powered offense, Georgia State.
Now the Panthers will inbounds to the far sideline. Inbounds to Johnson. Johnson driving on Shepherd, gets low off the glass, can't finish, no good. Rebound fought for. It's on the floor now, so Simi tied up with Bryce Williams. See what this whistle is. Bryce Williams calling for the foul. That'll be his third, 7 now on the team. And a 1-1 coming for the Panthers. Aleel Sosime is going to go to the line for the 1 on the bonus. Back on the floor now, Kane Williams. And going out is Colin Moore.
I mean, I guess the only positive right now, Sosime is the one who's going to the line and shooting a 1-1 right here. Big miss.
63% of the year, and he does miss. The Niners get the rebound. In the backcourt, Jameer Young with it. Guarded by Johnson, full court man-to-man. Gets it across the half-court line. Bounce pass to Milos, right back to Jameer, driving, but he's fouled. Unable to score, but goes to the free throw line after the foul. As the foul's going to be on Kane Williams.
And Jameer Young, the only thing that he had on his mind right there, ladies and gents, was getting to the basket. He wasn't looking at anybody else on the court. He was taking it to the hoop himself, taking matters to get into his own hands. Big free throws coming up right here from the sophomore.
And the first shot is up and good. He's got 19. That ends the 10-0 run for the Panthers. One more shot coming for Jameer Young. 2:09 to play here in regulation. 68-60. And the second one on the way, good. So for the first time this season in game 2, Jameer Young has 20 points. That is a game-high number right now. Niners trail by 7. They need some stops. Out top, Williams gives it up on the left side to Johnson. Williams gets it back, and he is fouled. No, he committed the offensive foul trying to hook a Niner. He was double-teamed out top, and trying to get through it, he kind of used his arm to clear out.
Yeah, whenever you said foul, I went, oh, man, hopefully that's not on Young right there. No, yeah, it was on Williams, and Williams just taking over this ball game in the first half and early in the second half as well. Here, big opportunity right here for the Niners. Need some good floor space to go against this Georgia State defense.
Shepherd step back three-pointer. Off the rim, no good. Supika trying to save it. Keeps it in play, but to Allen for Georgia State. And now Johnson. Johnson in the front court. The freshman from Durham getting a lot of time tonight, averaging 9 points a game coming into this one. Only three in the ballgame, 1 of 5, but he's done a good job running the offense. Roberts hasn't been a big factor tonight. Here's a foul on Shepherd as Williams put it on the floor, and Cain Williams will go to the free throw line now. Shepherd's third. Now, Justin Roberts hasn't been much of a factor at all, just 3 points on 1 of 7 shooting. If you thought coming in, if you had a night like that, you liked the Niners' chances, but some other players like Toppin with 16 and Allen with 14 and Cain Williams with 16 have stepped up. Even Boyson double figures with 10. He's been pretty quiet in the second half, but was big in the first half. Free throw attempt, no good, but so Simi's there to clear it up and put it back up and in. Missed the front end, but they got the stick bag bucket. The lead is back up to 9 with 1:11 to go. Niners need a bucket right here. Jameer Young to Shepherd. Shep on the outside, dribbles out top, and he's going to be fouled as Evan Johnson commits his third. And now Shepherd's going to go back to the free throw line where tonight he's 4 for 5.
And if you're the Niners, that's exactly what you want. You want to be able to go to the line and be able to get fouled early in the shot clock. So you're stopping the clock, which of course is almost at 6 men right now for Georgia State. The Panthers, and down by 9, could easily cut it to 7 right here for Shep.
Today's game brought to you in part by Ford. Ford is built to fit your lifestyle. Check out the great offers on the vehicles that'll help you win the day at buyfordnow.com. Learn why they're built for victory and built for the Carolinas. Contact your Carolina Ford dealer, proud partner of 49er Athletics. Now the first one is good for Shepherd, who has 14 points in the game. Misses the second one, and on the rebound, Milo Supika commits the personal foul, which will be his second. And now we'll march down the other side of the floor and again shoot some free throws. It'll be a 1-1 this time for the Panthers as well, with 1:03 left to go on the clock. Niners trail by 8.
And Shep just staring down that free throw attempt. Even after he missed it, he came back and said, you know what, I'm going to act like I'm shooting it one more time as well. We'll jump back down there on the block. So again, need to go ahead and box out right here if you're super cutting Bryce Williams on the low block.
So Simi at the line makes the first one. Lead is back to 9, so they again equal their largest lead. Charlotte, no field goals the last 5 minutes and 8 seconds. Now one more. No good. Rebound, Bryce Williams. And a foul on Georgia State. It's going to be on Colin Moore. So now it's a free throw contest.
Yeah, they're helping out the Niners right now at Georgia State, Matt. I mean, they're fouling without any seconds going off the clock. So, I mean, right now Sanchez and Fern and even Coach Kimball, they're saying, you know what, boys, we're still in this. We got to be able to knock down these open free throws, these game-winning shots, of course, and be able to cut into this league with just over a minute left.
Yeah, they've missed 7 free throws tonight. Bryce Williams shooting 2, and he misses. Niners 16 of 24 as a team at the foul line, just 12 of 18 in the second half. 62 seconds left to go in the game. Niners trail by 9. Second free throw coming for Bryce Williams, who's 1 of 5 of the line tonight. Does make this one. He's in double figures now as he has scored 10 points. Niners trail by 8. Inbounds to Cain Williams in the backcourt, guarded by Jameer, and Jameer is going to be called for a foul. That'll be his first team foul, number 10, so 2 free throws now for Georgia State. Jameer thought he had position.
Looks like he's the one who got nicked up on that.
Yeah, I think he took a shot. As Cain Williams had tried to get up, and the ball, I think, got him right in the midsection. Williams makes the first one. Now, Cain Williams, 17 points to now lead the Panthers. Toppin has 16. And Cain Williams now at 17. You make it 18. He made them both. So the lead is now 10. That is their largest lead of the game, and it comes with 59 seconds to go. Got a timeout. Going to stretch to a full timeout.
I'm out of breaks.
Going to keep it right here. Don't forget the Niners on Sunday afternoon at 12 noon. We'll get back on the football field. If all things go well, they'll take on the Hilltoppers of Western Kentucky. Our pregame coverage beginning at 10 and in the studio at 10 in the stadium at 11. Al Wallace and myself start the pregame show in stadium at 11 a.m. And we'll kick it off just after 12 noon. And then on Monday, right back here, 6 o'clock, the Niners back on the hardwood to take on South Carolina State. A lot going on. I think on Sunday, you'll be in Chapel Hill with the women, taking on the Tar Heels in Chapel Hill. And that'll be a good one. And the Niners came so close to beating Wake Forest last night right here.
They did, yeah. And Wake Forest receiving votes and just knocking off Missouri State, a top 25 team in the nation, in Wake Forest. And Charlotte, heck, led for the entire first half. And just late in the ballgame, Wake Forest has just had some better players. One of the best players in the country in that Ivana Raza, averaging like almost 20 and 10 a game. She'll definitely be in the WNBA next season. And here we go.
10-point lead for the Panthers. 59.3 seconds left to go. And Shepard's going to throw it inbounds to Matos in the backcourt. Shep gets it right back. He'll bring it up the floor. Got to move fast now. Shep to the right side. Gets it to Young. He'll take a jumper, a three-pointer, no good. On the rebound, it's going to be Georgia State. And Moore grabbing the rebound. He's fouled as Jameer Young came over and fouled him to stop the clock. And that'll be two fouls on Jameer in the game. So on the other end, more free throws. And tonight, Georgia State has made 7 of 10 in the second half and 14 of 20, 70% for the game.
Yeah, 13 for 19 in the second half for the Charlotte 49ers at the free throw line. I mean, heck, they were almost given 23 points in the second half and only able to capitalize on 13 of those. And I mean, that's one of the differences in the ball game. Of course, just Georgia State just bringing the energy, Matt, here in the second half and showing, hey, I know there's not too much energy you can have on the road during the normal times, and you have to bring your own energy, BYOE, on the road, and that's exactly what Georgia State and Coach Lanier did.
Moore missed the first but makes the second free throw to put him up 11 now. And the Niners will, with 44 seconds to go, bring it up ahead. Into the front court, Shepard dribbles towards the right, gets low, and he's going to be fouled by JoJo Tappan. That's three on Tappan, two free throws coming for Shepard. With 37.5 seconds to go. So, a little bit like the first game a week ago against East Carolina, the second 10 minutes of the second half is what has done this team in.
Yeah, and offensively, defensively, just breakdowns on the defensive side of things, turnovers. I mean, Matt, what we saw, I think almost three exact same turnovers right here at the free throw line. Just being able to poke the ball from the back. I think it was Johnson almost with all three of those steals. Him and Williams just able to put their hands in and come up with a lot.
Shepard makes both free throws. Now Bryce Williams on the inbounds fouls Moore with 36.6 seconds to go. It's a 9-point game. The Niners trying to extend this game as much as they can and hope that Georgia State starts to miss some of these free throws. Moore is going to be at the line. He's one of two at the line. Just stepping there a moment ago. Now back. And the first one is good. So it is now 75-65. Charlotte held the Panthers to 32 points in the first half, but right now 43 in the second half. Well, the Niners only have 29 here in the second half. And the second one by Moore is also good. Lead is back to 11. 34 seconds to go. Shepard brings it up ahead. Shep on the right of the key. Shep spins, gets low. Shot blocked by Tappan. Here comes Georgia State. Moore in the front court. Shot clock is off. They don't have to take a shot here. The Niners are not going to foul again. They can just dribble out the remaining 17 seconds. And Georgia State will get their third win of the season and for the first time ever beat the 49ers in Charlotte in this their 16th try. So a tough way to start the season for the Niners. They go to 0-2. Here comes the horn. The final score is 76-65 as Georgia State wins this one on the road by 11. They won last season in overtime in Atlanta and now make it 2 years in a row. The 30th meeting all time between the Niners and Georgia State goes to the Panthers. Stick around, our postgame show's coming up. 76-65 is our final tonight here at Halton Arena. This is Charlotte Basketball from Learfield. I'm Jay College.
It's
on Monday, if things go well, they'll take on South Carolina State, still in search of that first victory of the season. Trevor, your thoughts on the game? The Niners led at halftime, leading 36-32 at the break. Got off to a pretty good start in the second half, and then got to a point where they're trading baskets for quite a while with the Panthers. But in the end, the final 5 minutes, Georgia State, with some turnovers by the Niners, they made some threes and opened up a little bit of a cushion and then made their free throws down the stretch to win the ballgame.
Yeah, way too many turnovers for the Niners in the second half. And again, it's what they did last year in Atlanta against Georgia State, losing in overtime and allowing this team to come back again. You know, if you're the Charlotte 49ers and Sanchez, and I guarantee you Fern, Sfera, all the assistant coaches and all the players are saying to themselves, you know what? They're going to come back. They're still going to punch us back in the face, and we have to be able to take that and then be able to come back and say, you know what? We're a better team than them. Same thing against ECU. the Niners. They got punched whenever they were up 20-10 in the first half in that first game a week ago here at Halton Arena, and then they got punched and they were never able to come back. It says a lot about the character of this team. Whenever they go down, whenever the execution, whenever the energy is not going their way, something is just not clicking on the offense, and most importantly for Charlotte, that defensive end, and it's just not clicking. They're not able to withstand these punches right now from the opposing team. And again, Georgia State, a very high-powered offensive team, and we know they're going to stick the hand in cookie jar and come up with some stuff. But again, second half is way too many turnovers. What, it was just four turnovers in the first half for the Niners. Then they end up with nine in the second half. You're not going to get it done. That's your bread and butter. Second half, have to be able to execute. And Georgia State, they were the better team here tonight.
In the end, the Niners shot 39% as a team for the game. In the second half, just 26%, 6 of 23, and just 2 of 10 from the three-point line of the second half, and 15 of 21 at the free-throw line. Georgia State, 40% for the game, but to 42% in the second half. Plus, they made 6 threes, shooting 43% in the second 20 minutes, and made 10 of their 14 second-half free throws at 71%. And they outscored the Niners by 15 in the final 20 minutes, 44-29 in the second half for the 11-point road win. We'll come back more of the postgame show in a moment. And today's game has been brought to us by Atrium. When you need something these days, you go online and hunt for the best. And when it comes to finding the best health care, the choice is clear: Atrium Health, the only health system in the region nationally ranked by U.S. News and World Report. Learn more at atriumhealth.org/best. Get more of the postgame show coming up in a moment. Niners lose by 11 to Georgia State. This is Charlotte Basketball from Learfield, IMG College.
It's bow time.
So it's game time, and you got a bunch of rabid fans.
Dad, we're hungry.
You head out to fire up burgers and dogs and go from grill master to MVP, but...
No.
You're at a GAS. Drop a big bow box on it. Game on. Feed a family of four with 8 pieces of chicken, biscuits, fixings, and tea for just $19.99.
keeping every